Hey YouTube. Alright, this is a redo of another video I have. How to turn an MPEG4 file into an MPEG3 file. Music files they are. From iTunes. And I know it's irritating how you just can't right click a song and click create MP3 version. With some purchased music you can. Like, I bought 160 songs from Bonsai Works on iTunes Store, and you can easily just right click and push create MP3 version. Some purchased music, I recommend trying that before you try this. Okay, let's try this out now. So I'll just pick a few songs. Now what you're gonna have to do is create a folder, any folder you want. I'll just do purchased music, or you could just leave it untitled or untitled 1. And go to your songs that you want to pick. These are all my purchased songs I got from iTunes. Okay, and then, let's see, I'll do whatever, I'll just add random ones. Okay, so I'll pick, some songs. Okay. And you can pick numerous ones at one time by holding shift and clicking one and then another. Or you can hold control and click one. And then you can drag them to there too. Okay. Alright, so, instead of having to burn all these for the video, I'll just do 3, okay? So, do that right now. Then, change the order you want. I mean, it doesn't really matter if you're just doing this for the video, for what I'm doing for the video. Okay, so get a CD, let me pick one up. Alright, so I got one, now just let me put it in. Okay, and then I'll just wait for it to load. Alright, and then after it loaded up, you could do it anytime, and then it'll load, but what you do is have all your songs in your list and make sure they're all there, and then click burn disk right at the bottom right. Okay, and then this box should come up. This is for iTunes 8 and over. This is a new update. Now a box will come up and ask you for speeds. Just leave it at maximum possible. Gaps between the songs doesn't matter. All this doesn't matter, but just leave it as an audio CD. Just make sure it's checked as that. Then click burn. Alright, and then I'll just let this finish, and then after it's done, I'll show you what to do next. Alright, so it's finishing now. Alright, and after it's done, it should show you your purchased music. If your settings aren't set to where it'll open your CD drive, then you should be at this area. And if it is, just push your CD back in and click the playlist that you chose. But it should be under devices and should have a picture of a disc next to it. Alright, after it's done uploading, after it's done burning and after it's put in your computer again, go up here and click edit. It should be on the taskbar. Then click preferences. And then right down here in the general tab, about the middle of this, it should say, when you insert a CD, show CD, begin playing, ask to import CD, import CD, import CD, and eject. Just click show CD to where it's set to that so you don't have to open it again. You can check that if you want. Whenever you get your own CD. This is, alright, this is apart from the video, but whenever you get your own CD from the CD store or something like that, or Walmart, or whatever you go to get your CDs, check the box and it'll automatically find all your track names and put it together, so if you ever import it to your computer, it'll automatically have the names all on it instead of having to write them in. Then, click Import Settings, and click Higher Quality, and click where it says Import Using. It's automatically set to AAC encoder. Change that to MP3 encoder. Okay, and then click OK. Then click OK again on the preferences box. Then choose your songs, hold shift, and then choose all of them. Drag them to your library. And then I already have them there, so I'm just gonna click don't replace. But that's basically all you do, so. So it's importing, and it won't take 2 minutes to import a normal song. It'll take about 10 seconds, but the disc is just warming up, so that's it. Thanks for watching. Subscribe, rate, comment, and favorite, and I'm gonna try this. I don't know if I can do this, but it'd be nice if somebody could send a message and ask for a how-to video, because I don't do many of those. But if I can, then I'll do it, and I'll add your account name and channel. If I can't do it, then I'll privately tell you I can't, because I don't know everything. Alright, so thanks for watching. Subscribe, rate, comment, and favorite.